Imagine if every time you sat down to study, your brain was primed to absorb twice as much information, twice as fast, and remember it for twice as long as you normally do. Well, this isn't fantasy. If you combine the study techniques that we've told you about in other videos with a few easy new daily brain health habits, you can keep the blood flowing more smoothly to the right parts of your cerebral cortex to really boost your performance. I'm Andrew with Brainscape, an adaptive flashcard study app built on decades of proven cognitive science research into how we learn better. And aside from using Brainscape to study, the best way to learn faster is to juice your brain health through a combination of the right foods, movements, and mental activities that will improve your energy, sharpen your focus, lift your mood, and put your mind in an ultra-absorbent state for learning. Now, there's no shortage of advice on what specific foods to eat and avoid if you're going for optimal performance. You can head over to the Brainscape Academy if you're really looking for that complete grocery list. All I want to say here in this summary video is if you want to study effectively or perform well on a test or wherever, eat a diverse array of proteins, healthy fats, and vegetables, and less of anything processed with added sugars, salt, and preservatives. That's it. It's pretty simple. We've all heard this general advice a million times. So the tough part I want to focus on here isn't the knowledge of what's healthy, it's developing good eating habits. After all, everyone knows that raw almonds are healthier than Flamin' Hot Cheetos, but that doesn't mean it is any easier to lose weight. The key is to make it easy and convenient to follow good eating habits. Try buying the same online grocery list each week, or prepping your food for the week every Sunday, or eating pretty much the same breakfast or lunch every day so you don't have to think about it, or keeping healthy snacks in your backpack so you're more likely to munch on them, or maybe saving all your junk food for a cheat day only once a week so you have fixed rules. This is just a start. You could read tons more about developing good habits and willpower over at the Brainscape Academy, but the main point here is if you automate the availability of healthy foods so you don't have to make decisions every time you're hungry, you free up that mental bandwidth for things like studying or socializing, and you'll lead a richer and healthier life. Tip number two is water, the essence of life. You don't need to be a farmer to know that crops do a lot better with water. Living things simply need circulation of fluids to keep our cells working the best. That's why your brain is 73% water. The better hydrated your brain, the smoother it's working. When you're hungover and groggy, it's because your brain is dehydrated. I'm sure you've heard the experts say that every adult should drink about 8 cups of water a day, and ideally, you should, but that shouldn't be sugary beverages, with the exception of maybe a few squirts of fresh orange or lemon or strawberries or cucumber because you hate the taste of water or something. Either way, to develop good hydration habits, try carrying a refillable water bottle with you all the time and set a goal for how many bottles you wish to polish off each day. Another thing I do is I keep a bottle of water right by my bed when I go to sleep. The second I hear my alarm go off in the morning, I chug that whole thing and then I pass back out to snooze. Inevitably, I'm gonna have to get up to pee in like 20 minutes. So not only is this morning chugging routine gonna help get your snoozing ass out of bed, it will water your dehydrated morning brain so you can hit the ground running. Our next brain optimization tip is about getting that sleep in the first place. And if you suck at sleeping, like I do, you're probably sick of hearing how important sleep is, as that only stresses you out even more. I wish I could tell you that there's some amazing, safe, non-addictive pill you could take to fall asleep immediately and counteract the caffeine you probably drank in the 10 hours before bedtime, even though you shouldn't have. But at the end of the day, the biggest thing keeping you up isn't some chemical imbalance, it's what's going on in your brain. You're thinking about all that unfinished business, all the social interactions you had today, and everything you have to do tomorrow. The best defense against this? Get your stuff done yesterday. Not with a time machine, I mean constantly plan ahead and keep your to-do list as clear as possible at the end of the day so you never have to get stuck staying up late, cramming, or thinking about something. Of course, there will still be tons of nights where you have a lot of outstanding tasks still hanging over your head. So in those cases, just get up out of bed and write down a detailed to-do list for tomorrow, if you haven't already. It's amazing how getting stuff down on paper can free your brain to turn off so you can finally get the sleep you need to recharge. And speaking of recharging, your brain needs some form of exercise to really keep those juices flowing right. This doesn't have to be a long, boring treadmill session. It could be a sport, it could be yoga. Ideally, anything that requires a little bit of concentration and exertion to activate that motor cortex. I'm not gonna sit here and try to be your personal trainer unless you bribe me, but I can give you a tip to help address the biggest problem for busy students, which is finding time for exercise. And that tip is studying while you exercise with Brainscape's new 40-pound lead flashcards. Just kidding. Seriously, if you've made or found all your flashcards already in Brainscape, then you've prepped yourself to study and work out at the same time. Just pop open the Brainscape app on your phone while you're sitting on an exercise bike or an elliptical and go through and rate all your confidences in each flashcard, which will make them repeat in the right intervals without you ever having to think too much while you're huffing and puffing. And bonus, you'll feel better about yourself for studying than you typically do by just watching those trashy reality show reruns at the gym. Another idea, especially if you already know the material pretty well, or if you're doing something like mountain biking where you don't have free hands, try just freely recalling everything you know about the topic that's going to be on your test in your head, as if you're planning to teach a beginner about it. Some people call this free recall strategy the Feynman technique. We have a video about it. And it can be a great way to solidify that knowledge while you're also getting a good workout. And finally, just as it's important to pump up your brain, you also need to be able to unwind your anxieties to free up space for learning. First, identify what is really stressing you out. Ask several levels of why. Why is this really affecting me so much? And then really try to think of it like an outsider, like you're giving yourself advice. Rather than feeling like a victim or complaining to people, I have so much work to do, I'm gonna fail my test, I'm so out of shape, or whatever's stressing you out, give yourself an out-of-body experience. Notice the anxiety as if you're a third party. You're just saying, oh, hello, anxiety. How are you doing today? Rather than becoming the anxiety. This change from a victim mindset to an agent mindset will allow you to get psyched about the challenge ahead of you rather than intimidated. Remember, every strong, successful person in the world got that way, not because they were born that way, but because they built a resistance to thousands of stressful experiences over time, and they still fight stress today. Just knowing that can help you to practice gratitude next time you have an opportunity to beat a stressful experience ahead of you. Thank the world for giving you this opportunity to strengthen your resistance. If you could really make it a habit to incorporate these five things into your life, healthy food, water, sleep, exercise, and mindfulness, you will not only win at school, but you will win at life with great habits that will last you forever. Because a sharp brain is the best tool that you have to rise to your challenge.